All right, Shalom. First and foremost, giving all praise, glory, and honor that's due to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rachakwadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone who rule well. Peace and blessings to the 144,000 and the hopeful elect, Shalom, Barakatam. And I wanted to speak on the lesson. The thing that was on my spirit, man, and it's in transit, is fear and how the Lord really has reversed circumstances, even though it doesn't feel like it. All right, because I was just meditating on what it would be like, you know, if we were back on those plantations back in chattel slavery, which, you know, we were in our previous lives, all right, which we never got, you know, our payback for, but the Lord's gonna do that, I believe, some of it back in this lifetime, you know. But I was just imagining what it would be like. And what it would be like a waking nightmare, man. You ever had something that's called night terrors? Now, night terrors are a little different from nightmares. A nightmare is just a horrific dream, or a dream that really riles you up in your spirit, you know, while you sleep. But night terrors are layers of those nightmares. Like, you have a nightmare, but then you wake up and you think it's still, you think you're awake, but then you're really just inside of another dream. I've had that happen before, where I dreamt that I woke up out of a dream, out of a nightmare, but I hadn't. You know, I was just in a different layer of a nightmare, like kind of like Inception, man. That's what it would be like living on those plantations, man. That horrific fear, you know. And the reason I'm on the topic of fear is because now the Lord has basically flipped it, because our enemies fear us now in the same way. Now, are they afraid that we're gonna put them to death if they look at one of our women? No, but they are frantic, all right? They're insecure, man. And honestly, they can read the spiritual tea leaves, so to speak, all right, about which direction this thing is going. This is why their self-deletion rate is so high, all right? And I was listening to the guy, Tariq Nasheed, earlier, about how these Edomites, man, they are extremely terrified, you know. They're terrified on multiple fronts. Number one, they're afraid of being replaced. They have something called the Great Replacement Theory, right? Which, with all the immigrants are gonna come in and replace the white jobs, the white race, all right? They're afraid of their women leaving them, man, okay? And ultimately, they are afraid of losing their power, their hegemony around the world, because they're afraid of the consequences of what's going to happen, man. The only reason that you need to be that afraid about another nation getting power is if you've done those other nations wrong, which they did. They're afraid of the birth rates, because their birth rates are declining, man. And they measure birth rates by their women, all right? They look at how many children do women have, how many childbirths per year per woman, all right? And if it's below 2, then you're not at replacement. You're not at replacement level, meaning you're going to die out eventually if you don't have at least 2.1 on average kids per woman, all right? And I think Esau, he's at like 1.9. It's probably much lower. You know, they get a little wishy-washy and suspect with the term white. You got a lot of Northern Kingdom consider themselves white, and we know Northern Kingdom they reproduce a lot. All right, so there's a lot of Northern Kingdom that's probably even in those white numbers, man. All right. So their actual Edomite birth rate is much lower that I believe than what they're reporting, man. But they're afraid of being replaced, man. This is causing a lot of anxiety. It's causing a lot of tension. And now you're just starting to realize that the community known as the incels, it's primarily Esau, man. It's primarily Edomites. It's these awkward, weirdo white dudes. All right, that can't get no box from their own women, because their women are going toward their enemy, man. All right, And this is what happens when you let women run rampant. Okay? When you just say it's an open dating market, you can only marry one person. All right? And all of the, and now you know, and he's revoked his own laws too. That's the last point I'll make. And so when your women is going towards other men, that's just a sign that your nation is going down. Apostle Hart brought that out. He said, when your woman is going with the enemy, with Jake, man, you know you're on your way out, man. And that's a major fear of them, man. And why did all of this happen? It's because his own people at the very top, y'all have had a civil war, all right, economically, all right, and culturally, okay? Y'all decided to mix and mingle everything together, all right, at the middle and lower class level, while the elites are like, well, look, we gonna still preserve our people, you know, but we gonna get this money. You gotta deal with these with these immigrants and these other people from all walks of life, all right, and that's what you gotta deal with, you know. And what's happened? Esau is now he's collecting more welfare than anybody else. All right, he's the most likely to shoot a school up. All right, he's the most depressed. He has the highest self-deletion rate. His women are leaving him at a rapid rate. I've never seen so many white women fucking with Jake, man. And Keisha mad. Who cares? You know. It is easier than ever to get a white woman, and this is coming from a time period where you couldn't even look a white woman in the eyes, man. All right, and so just know that now they fear us more than we fear them, man. You know, and so what's gonna happen coming soon? Lord willing, he's gonna get back in that old spirit. He's gonna lose it, man. He's gonna be like that shy, timid kid that everybody picked on, made fun of. But that's what's happening right now. He's being called incel and weak, and you know these feminists and people in the rainbow community, they hate, you know, straight white males. You know, they're on his head. But just like that kid that got bullied in school, he's gonna come back to school one day and shoot that motherfucker up. That's what's getting ready to happen with Esau, man. All right, all of society is basically at a breaking point. All right, but that's in Deuteronomy 30:7, man, that the curses will turn on our enemies, okay? And the Most High promised that we would see the downfall of our enemies, man. So this is all a righteous thing, you know, because they never paid back anything, nor did they ever plan on paying back anything, man. All right? They didn't pay reparations. They didn't make you whole again. They constantly stole and took things from you, all right? They didn't restore they didn't even restore our names, our language. They didn't give us nothing, man. All right? Meanwhile, they pivoted their focus on taking from the rest of the world, man. They went through all of these different nations and started these coups and gave them the U.S. dollar, or forced it on them, rather. All right? They siphoned out all of their resources. Africa is being spoiled, basically, man. They're being robbed, you know? How you letting Edomites come in there and pay you monopoly money to take real minerals out of the ground, cobalt and all this other stuff? Hey, here's some monopoly money for it. You know, you live in dirt poor. You got one sandal, all right. And the minerals and the riches are in your land. Okay. Guys like Elon Musk come in there and start, you know, swinging his proverbial dick around like he runs the place, man. All right. And truthfully, they do, because that really is the offer you can't refuse. Because if you say, nah, we want to keep our own minerals and build them for ourselves, like Nigeria and West Africa, they got a lot of uranium, all right? If they decided one day, like, no, we're not going to sell it to France, we're going to keep it for ourselves, well, he's going to send in the military, man, because even though he asked to trade with you for it, for dirt cheap, all right, really that wasn't he wasn't asking, you know? He's just trying to avoid, you know, a diplomatic situation. A geopolitical situation, you know. Because he's got to convince people that he's, you know, what he's doing is righteous. That's what Darwinism was about. You know, when they came up with the origin of species. Alright? That was his way of explaining away why he was justified in treating us worse than a goddamn dog, man. You know? So, all that to say, man, is we have the high ground, man. Even though Jake is broke, you know, even though, you know, it don't look like we ever gonna get our lick back, it's all good because the Most High is destroying his society through him, okay? His behavior is self-destructive. So it's really just a matter of time, you know, before they destroy themselves. But we know we're on the timeline of prophecy, okay? The Lord is going to do it in the way that he said he was going to do it. It was going to be done, all right? So all we have to do, man, is watch, keep, stay locked in, all right? Be circumspect, man. Watch your surroundings, okay? Because these people are becoming irrational. They're becoming, you know, irritable, you know? And they're mad, man. They're angry, okay? You're going to have people rolling up to camps, you know? And everything that's compounding on top of this pressure, it's all economic pressure, man. They've always been thinking about this. They've always been mad. But now they can't afford eggs now. On top of that, you know, you see, and they're supposed to be the ones in rulership. So all of these things are going to compound, man. So this is an exhortation that we need to keep doing, stay the course on what we're doing, but also we need to move wisely and circumspectly because our enemy, all right, is looking to harp down on us, man. And everybody's bringing this out, man. All right. People are starting to realize, man, this guy is not it, man. You know? So, you know, with that, man, I'll end it there, man. Stay encouraged. Keep watching. Keep the faith, man. You know, keep your eyes single on this thing, man. Because we are the righteous ones, man, not them. We have the moral high ground, man, not them. The Lord is with us, not with them. So we really have nothing to fear. They do, you know? So I'll end it there, man. Lord willing, this was edifying. Call halal Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai Bahashir Khakadash Shalom from Yashiro.